I never ever thought that Ghanaians would tolerate the level of nepotism in government that we see today. I never ever thought. In our case, one of our own said I was running a family and friends government. A family and friends government, and MPP took it up. Family and friends, the government is full of his family and friends. Why? When I had no blood relation of mine in government, except for some lowly deputy minister, she's supposed to be here somewhere. Joyce Bauer. My auntie's daughter. Only blood relation of mine in my government. And yet, said family and friends, family and friends. And when you ask, where are they? They say, oh, by your own person said it. Now today, look at it. And yet, that's the new standard. Civil society is quiet. Religious leaders are quiet. Traditional leaders are quiet. When NDC comes the next time, and Alabi or Bagbin or who is the president, and they appoint their relatives into government, are they now going to come out and say it? Must the standards of measuring governance differ because of who is in the presidency? That is the hypocrisy of our politics. That is the height of the hypocrisy we have in Ghana. Something is pardonable when one government is in power, but when one government comes in power, it's unpardonable. Things that the media would have made so much noise about under my administration. I mean, it happens every day and it's like business as usual. That is the hypocrisy of our civil society and our religious leaders and traditional leaders. Everybody's quiet. Shut up. Suddenly everything is fine. Some say now they don't watch TV again, they watch animals. In our time, they were not watching animals. They were listening to political discussions. They're tired of politics, too much politics. You're tired. Because you're dialing this thing, government is super incompetent. So you're tired of hearing the analysis. That's the hypocrisy we face in our country. So let us not buy into their propaganda.